Peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the gatekeeper or the host of this program, known here on social media, wherever you may find me. I am known as the mighty Angel Snubbed Up 7. I am your soul brother, number one. I want to wish everyone a happy Savior's Day. The Nation of Islam, those who believe in the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, whose teacher was or called Master Farah Muhammad, was born February 26th. 1877, I believe. And on the weekend of his birth, every year, the Nation of Islam celebrates the coming of a savior, and that savior to the black man and woman in America is called Wallace Farad or Master Farad Muhammad. On this platform, we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry because my roots comes from the Nation of Islam. I have established our version of Savior's Day, of which we don't dedicate to a certain person, but we dedicate to the strength in ourselves, and we call it Soul Liberation Day. And if you have not checked out or don't know of our Savior's Day, then please feel free to watch what we have to say for Savior's Day, but we call it Soul Liberation Day 2024. And the theme was free your mind and the rest will follow, inspired by these ladies, the Funky Divas of Soul, ǎterna. A savior has been born for the black man and woman in America. We're looking for a man, not a woman. Even though it takes a woman to bring man onto this planet, we don't know, we have not experienced no other way. But she gets little fanfare. We don't really talk about her. Even women don't care about her role in the Savior. A man is coming to save us. We're never looking for a woman. So if the man is the Savior, we should not blame the woman for nothing, because that's not her responsibility. That's not her role, except to spit the Savior out. Bloop, there you go, boy. Go save the world. And you really don't care anything about her. All eyes on the man, the Savior. So the question I want to raise before we actually get into our topic, because it is about manhood, the question I want to raise is, we've looked for these men, not only Master Farah Muhammad, but Jesus is a man, and all the prophets and everything about the Savior. Because we never are taught about a, I guess you could say, Savioress. A female. So we're looking for a man. And we've been looking for a man for thousands of years to save us. I raised the question, why aren't we saved? Why are we still talking about this? Because if this person was a savior or is a savior, and we have been saved, and it's according to what time they came, we should be saved. So Master Farah Muhammad is the savior, and he came to us, Allah in the person, July 4th, 1930. It is 2024 now. And we're still talking about a savior. If the savior didn't save us in 1930, what make you think that the savior can save us in 2024? If the savior did not save you 2,000 years ago, what make you think the savior can save you in 2024? The fireman saved their lives in 2010. And you see them walking around just fine. Hey man, you was in a fire. Oh, I'm not in a fire no more. I thank the firemen, they saved my life. But oh, but that was back in 2010, because I was saved. You don't save nobody, and it takes thousands and hundreds of years to save them. That defeats the purpose of saving. If I'm in a fire, I need saving right now. I need to get out this fire. If I'm being robbed in my store, I need a police officer right now. I cannot wait tomorrow or next week. I need to be saved today. So this doesn't make any sense that we wait hundreds and thousands of years for a savior. And we're still talking about we're not saved. So clearly, either that was not the Savior, or the Savior was incompetent because we are not saved. We should not have a meeting every year talking about our Savior has arrived. Well, if our Savior has arrived, we should be saved, but we're not. And if you notice, the people that actually bring us benefit don't call themselves a savior. The fireman, the policeman. Dr. Martin Luther King never called himself a savior. I never heard Malcolm X call himself a savior. I never heard the Black Panther Party or Harriet Tubman or any of these with boots on the ground that sacrificed and some died in the struggle. I never heard them call themselves a savior, but the savior, those of whom we wait for, have done little for us. But those who don't claim to be a savior, we benefit more so than from the actual people that we've been waiting hundreds and thousands of years for. It doesn't make sense, people. And if it doesn't make any sense, it's not true. There's only one savior, or maybe perhaps two. The first savior is what can you do for yourself? And the second savior is the assistant, because I'm trying to save myself in this water, but I can't swim. I'm doing the best I can. So you need assistance. And that savior jumps in the water, putting their own life in danger to save your life. I don't have faith in your saviors no more. Because I'm not going to wait 100 years. I'm not going to wait 1,000 years to get saved. You need to be saved now. So with all disrespect, with no disrespect, it does not make any sense to wait on Jesus. It makes no sense to wait for Master Farah Muhammad. Clearly they cannot save you. What are they saving you from? Because if you tell me what they're supposed to be saving you from, and you still suffering, you still are being affected by the condition, you're not saved. What's taking so long for them to save you if they are the Savior? The job of the police officer, the job of the fireman, the job of, don't even have to be a job if somebody see you in trouble. They act now. They do something to resolve your problem now. They don't wait tomorrow. You need help now. So I cannot say that Jesus is my savior because I'm still in the same condition. Nothing has changed. I cannot say Master Farah Muhammad is my savior. I'm still in the same condition. Nothing has changed. I cannot call him. I cannot call God a savior because I'm still in the condition that I am even after 1,000 years go by. It don't make any sense, people. Just rituals that make us feel good. You don't need to feel good when you're in a fire because that fire burning you up. You need to get out of the fire. You don't need no ritual when somebody pull a gun on you, your money or your life. You need a police officer on the scene. You need help. You need a solution now. So my question is, what kind of saviors are these? What are they doing for you? Because you're not saved. I cannot do it. And as a man, such thinking is unacceptable. Because if I'm a man and I love my family, I need help now. I'm a man and my family is trapped in a fire. I need a savior now. And if a man is not going to wait for a savior, he's going to take the situation in his own hands to the best of his ability. Because he's not going to wait tomorrow and a few hours. I need to save my family now. What kind of saviors are these? Master Farah Muhammad is not my savior. But if it was not for Master Farah Muhammad, I would not be talking to you right now. And maybe Master Farah Muhammad himself could not save, but maybe because of what he started, he put into motion that which could bring or make us saved. But you shouldn't have to wait 100 years and 1,000 years. You need to be saved now. And most people that want to be saved, because that's what they want. You cannot save somebody that don't want to be saved. You cannot help somebody who don't want to help themselves. What do it look like for a fireman to climb up the ladder and the person run back into the fire? So who's to say, who said that these want to be saved? Who asked to be saved? And maybe that's the reason why you're willing to wait 100 years and 1,000 years, because you don't want to be saved anyway. Because those who are in need of saving are in big trouble. I need to get out of this situation now. You don't want to be saved. It's a ritual. You go to Savior's Day just like going to church. Put on your suit and your bow ties and sell your pies and sing. You don't sing and dance like that, but you it's the same stuff, going to church. So how dare you make mockery of our black Christians when you are black power and you do the same thing? You just go to your church and you think your church is better than their church because your Jesus is black. Or your Jesus speaks Arabic or Hebrew, but y'all all gone to church. And we make profits out of our freedom fighters. So Malcolm is something to worship, a prophet of the new church. John Henry Clark and Dr. Ben, the figures, the prophets, and the messengers of a Pan-African church. Our Savior has arrived. When did the Savior arrive? Because you're still in the same condition. And ain't nothing changing. Because you listen to DVDs. Ain't nothing changed. Because you went to the lectures and you went to the debates and you gave so-and-so cash apps. If your Savior has arrived, you should be saved. But I have to respect those things, because if it was not for those things, I would not exist. This is why we must mature. At one time, you believed in Santa Claus and the Easter Bunny or some other story. But as you grow up, as you mature, you remember some of the lessons to learn from those stories, but you know it's just a story. As you mature, nobody don't have to tell you, you know, those were just fairy tales. They were just stories. Since 1930, when Master Farah Muhammad first appeared, he gave us a story. He gave you stories. Because he knew that we had an immature mind, a childish mindset. But as time goes on, you're supposed to mature. You're supposed to evolve, and you see some of that, a little taste. But in 2024, you're still there. You're still in 1930, 1950, 1970. Some of y'all go all the way back 5,000, 6,000 BC. Like, damn. Instead of going forward, you're going backwards. Instead of progressing, you're digressing. You cannot even replicate what they did in 1930. You can't replicate what they did 5,000 BC. You claim that Kemet had all this science and whatever. You can't even replicate none of it. The only thing you can do is talk. We used to do this and we used to do that. We used to. Do it now. Nobody care about what you used to be, what you used to do. And you get angry and upset because you can't replicate. I'm doing the best I can. Well, nobody want to hear that. I'm doing the best I can. Nobody want to hear that. Mr. Man, let's talk about Mr. Man. I'm going to tell you the reason why you're doing these things, because you lack manhood. You think that you are a man. I've had guests, men guests come here. Those who follow this platform know how I talk. Those who just visit, I can tell the men really don't like what I have to say about manhood, about us. See, there's body language, and I'm looking at your eyes. I'm watching your movements. I know you don't like, but see, I'm so strong here. You won't challenge what I have to say. You'll keep it to yourself. Why is that? You are mad. Speak up. Why are you holding your tongue? Speak up. You're not going to do it because you know your idea and what you believe manhood is weak, because you know you weak. Let's talk about manhood. Sisters, y'all can watch, y'all can listen. I'm talking to the so-called men. And the sad thing about it, y'all so damn weak, you can't even listen to words. That's how weak you are. You are afraid of words. So if you are afraid of words, we know that you are afraid of nuclear weapons and AK-47s and grenade launches and all these things that these men are dealing with day in and day out. You don't know nothing about the body bags. All kinds of body bags are being brought out in the Ukraine war. They don't like to show that because it's bad for morale. It's bad for the morale of those who are fighting to see, like, damn, they're killing the hell out of us. It's bad for the nation to see your soldiers going to the morgue. But that's the reality of Mr. Man in this civilization. And you don't have that experience, Mr. Man, Mr. God. You don't have that experience. I might not have to cross that line, but parental discretion is advised. I probably won't cross the line, but just in case the Holy Spirit kicks in, and when the Holy Spirit kicks in, you don't know where the Holy Spirit gonna take you. So parental discretion is advised. I've been wanting to do this talk for a little bit. I don't know where to start. It's so much to cover. But we want to lay down the foundation. Those of you who build a house, you know the most important thing about a house, or really whenever you're doing anything, you want to build a strong foundation. So whatever we don't get to today, then when we talk about it later, we've laid down the strong foundation, and the weak men don't want to continue that conversation because they won't be able to qualify. I call us men by default. You're not a man. You called a man because you have a penis. You're a man by default. I know many of these don't like hearing that because they feel as though they're a good man. But see, there's different levels of manhood. When I was a little boy, as most little boys, you know that you're not female. So you are naturally attracted to your own gender. You want to be a man. You want to see, what is it I want to be when I grow up, when I become an adult? Oh, wow, that's what I'm going to be. And even as a little boy, some of you may have felt that way. When I looked at the men around me, I looked at my father and grandfather and uncles and male cousins, when I and the preachers, the pastors, and the, when I looked at them, I had respect. Of course, as a child, I gave them respect. I just did not feel that essence I wanted to be. Even as a little boy, I don't want to be. I did not feel from them no more than I was when I was a child, I was a little boy. I did not see something stronger than myself, and I was a boy. So I'm thinking to myself, what makes them a man? I didn't know nothing about sex, so I didn't know what that was. Is it building a house, having a job? What is it? What is it? Because I don't see nothing strong about them. I was not attracted to their manhood. And then as I matured, I felt a little something when I was introduced to the fruit of Islam, the FOI, the Nation of Islam teaching. And I saw those men, because I'd never heard nothing like that before, how they talked and the things they said and how they move. I like that. So I want to be like that. I want to grow. I want to be an FOI. I want to be a man. That's what I viewed as a child. As a teenager. But as we experience life, as we grow, we begin to mature. What we was yesterday, we're not today. We begin to grow. What you was at 8 years old, hopefully you're not at 35. Unfortunately, there are those of you, you act the same way you did when you was in high school. You just a older version of a high school person. That's a shame. This is a big problem. We don't mature. Perhaps because we don't know how. Perhaps because our examples of maturity has not matured. So we think adulthood is supposed to be what they represent, because they have not matured. So is that our fault? So what we know is that there is a difference between males and females. We're not going to talk about females, and I might try to deal with that, but I'm not a female. It's only so far I could go, because I'm not a female, and that's not my concern. My concern is with my gender, getting my gender right. Because if my gender is the leader, if my gender is the head of the household, and my gender is the one that's running everything, then I know if my gender gets itself right, everything else will fall where it needs to be. Because the male is supposed to be the foundation of the family. The male is supposed to be the leader. The male is the strongest physically in the family, the leader. So if the family fail, or you, this is another thing we like these titles. I'm the leader. But when things go wrong, you should have, you're the leader. If you go to McDonald's and the fries not right, the quarter pounder not right, whatever, you don't go to the person on fries, you go to the leader, who is the manager. Look, I keep getting these bad fries, this quarter pounder is whack. I want to see the manager. The manager or the leader is responsible because they the leader. So they accept the responsibility for everything right. They also accept the responsibility for everything wrong. Men all over the earth don't want to accept responsibility when things is wrong. And usually they are the reason why it's wrong, because of their leadership. They don't want to talk about, they don't want to talk about women or anybody as long as everything going good. It's all about me. Look what we did. But as soon as things go wrong, well, the women should have did this, and the women, and you the leader. You got to take the bad with the good. They don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear you the leader. And many of them, or in this society or civilization, they lead by fear. They will kill you. They will give you severe punishment. So you got people that will obey you because they don't want to be punished. So it is your fault that things going bad, because you have submission. They don't want to do it that way. So we talk about man and woman. We know that there's biological differences. Women in their natural state have a different mindset. The females that we complain about, the females that we know of and interact with, haven't been influenced by males. Because I know that's not their mindset. That's not natural for them. They copying men. Whether they wear pants or a dress, they copying men. Because that's all we've known for thousands of years. If we look at the earth and we look at what's going on, and we don't like it, men done it. Women don't have nothing to do with this. Women to these women, just follow. All these gods and all of it male. These women don't follow no female god. If you follow female god, please put it in the chat room. Your female god. All the gods, all the spirits, all this is male. It's a gay orgy. A gay spiritual orgy. Nothing but men. Nothing but male. Nothing but worship of the penis. And that's where the women are at. Doing the same thing. How can you be a woman, a female, and you never want to see your own gender doing nothing? It's all about the men. So there's man and there's male. Male simply means you was born with a penis. And man is the adult form of what this male is supposed to grow into. Man. Now, you cannot teach. There's a fallacy that only a man can teach a boy how to be a man. That's yes and no. You shouldn't have to teach a male how to be a male. That should be natural for us. You shouldn't have to be taught to be a male. I don't see no gender confusion in male tigers or male elephants or male dogs or whatever. There's no confusion. When they are born male, they know what the hell they are. There's no other male lion or something to teach them, well, you know you're a male lion and us male lions, they don't have to teach them nothing. You're supposed to know because that's what you are. You will figure it out. Your nature will guide you. But see, in this civilization, in this world, by boys, not by man, by boys, they have destroyed the natural way of things. And they have corrupted the female's womb. And so now, and he's also corrupted his own sperm with alcohol, all types of drugs, all types of chemicals in your food. We are what we eat, then this is going to affect the egg and the sperm. So what kind of product are you going to get if the egg and the sperm is corrupt? You're not producing the best physically. Physically, you're not producing the best person. And then, since their brain is malformed, that's why y'all can't think worth a damn. You have to be taught common sense. You come into this world and cannot function. And you got to find somebody to help you think because you can't think for yourself. And you gravitate towards another person that can't think. The blind leading the blind. You shouldn't have to teach a boy how to be a boy. But you have to. And many of these are not going to accept that anyway, because I knew when I was born, I was a little girl. I'm in the wrong body. Men cause this. You don't see this in nature. There's no homosexual community where the lions live. There's no homosexual community where the beavers live or the ants. This is a man-made thing because of male leadership. And your gods and your spirits and your demons, all of it is part of it. Because we don't have no man. Man don't exist. All these is boys. Boys fighting in Ukraine, boys fighting in Israel, boys, they just nothing but a bunch of boys. They have the same mentality as the little children on the playground and the sandbox. Well, let's get to this. There is no man. Nobody has one. You have a lot of boys, you have boys in control of the world. And the poor black woman, your boy don't have nothing at all. That's why you in such bad shape, because you can't get nothing going. So this is why we live how we live, because boys put us in this condition. You're a grown man. Who knows how many women you've been in and out of? And seeing some booty or a vagina, you still get all excited. That's what little boys do, because all that is new to them and their hormones is kicking in. Ooh, look at her. Ooh, her booty really fat. Ooh, look at her. Ooh, look at that. You done already looked at it for the last 40, 50 damn years. What the hell are you getting excited about? You got 13 damn children. What you excited about? Boys. Boys. Social media. The only thing on these men's mind is booty hole. How to get some pussy. Boys. Like they ain't never had, never ever seen nothing. Because they boys. When you become an adult, there's higher things that you got to worry about and deal with. And as a black man on this planet, a soul brother, a black American or freedman, a black foundation American, however you want to call ourselves, we are in deep doo-doo. We need a savior. We need a man to arrive. We need a man. If anybody need a man in their life, it's us. We need that man. So you know, and there's no man that can claim you can teach a boy what is natural to him. Because that's you can't teach that. It's natural. Now what you can teach, and even a woman can teach, but it's better for the male to teach manhood because that's our gender. A woman can teach that, but that's not her job. She's not a, and there's only so far she can really go because, well, she's not a male. She can teach it. She know about your damn body. I asked them, what is it that a female can teach that male, or can't teach the male that the man's supposed to be able to teach that boy? I have yet to see. Put it in the chat room. What is it that a man can teach a boy that a woman can't? Put it in the chat room. Women play football. Women fix cars. Women in the military. They shoot AK-47 and grenade launchers. What the hell is it that with your arrogant self that this boy, what you gonna teach this boy? She know about your dang-a-lang. She know how your dang-a-lang work. She can teach him about that. She know about your damn purity. What is it that you gonna teach this boy that woman can't teach? Mr. Man. She can do it. It's not her job. It's not her gender. But she got to do it because your happy ass leave. You don't give a damn about your children like that. Go to family court and see how many brothers, I love my children. Go to any family court. It's free. So you don't want to go because you're lazy. You don't want to go because you don't want to really know the truth. Go to family court and watch the brothers fight for their children. Ain't nobody fighting. They don't want no half cuss. A lot of these guys, they cannot take care of themselves. They don't want those children. They don't want to be bothered taking children to the doctor, going to the basketball, whatever these children got to do. These men don't want to be bothered with that. They just want poo-tang and go about their business. It's so many of these guys that have children run around here like they single. I'm single. I have no children. You have children. And you run around here talking like you don't have any children. Well, she won't let me. Show the court record where you did all that you could to get your children, and then maybe what you're talking about is valid. You will not see that. Show us the court. These people don't go to court. They don't try. They don't do nothing. So, of course, the one who is actually taking care of the children, The court is the one, is of course, is going to be the one that gets all the attention from the court. Of course. Your ass ain't doing nothing. They don't never say that. I listen to these videos, and what I want to see, what do you do to see your children? Then these people not doing a damn thing. They cannot even take care of themselves. You can't take care of yourself. What the hell, you in a bed with a woman making babies and can't take care of yourself? Boys, I told you, boys, keep your dingling in your damn pants. This is 2024. All kinds of birth control crap. I don't like it. You don't like paying child support either. You don't even, most men of these men don't even like children. You can say that to these other people because many of them doing the same thing. They're not taking care of their children, running around here like they single. That's why they would be on your side, because they doing the same thing. They accepting that excuse. Mr. Man, let's talk about manhood. I haven't even began to touch my notes yet. I haven't even began to touch my notes. It's sickening. You want a title that you don't earn. I'm a man. You ain't no damn man. You're a mandingo. Yeah, you're a man. Mandingo. A stud horse. A breeder. That's what you do best, breeding. And that's the only way you can feel like a man. Look at my children. Look at my son. Look at my daughter. Look at my... You never said, look at the building. The skyscraper I just put up. Look at that river. I changed the route of that river. Now the river is going to serve me. You never talk about that. Talk about your... The cars that you putting off the line. You don't talk about that. Talk about this forest that I control. Look at my nuclear power plant. Oh, look at my kids. Look at my dog Scruffy. That's the best yo man ass can do. I told you, boys. Boys with a ding-a-ling. And these women don't know no better. Because they never had a man before. As long as you look cute, put on a pretty suit, and say some punk-ass thing, and most of the time it's damn lies. And she'll spread her legs. And you get happy.
I'm finna get me some, brother.
I was watching your video, but I'm finna get me some. I'll check the video later. That's what I'm gonna do. Boys! Boys. Anybody can make a baby. Dogs make babies. Goats make babies. Cats make babies. What make you different, Mr. Man? They don't want to hear this kind of talk. You can't even handle talking. You come challenge me on this, Mr. Man. You're not going to challenge me on this, weak ass. Because you're a boy. The white man got it right calling you a boy. He knew exactly what he was dealing with. Boy. And ain't nothing changed. He give you some candy. Give you a little money. Send your happy ass on your way. And you happy. You know that's how... We do children. Here's a quarter. Here's a quarter. Here's a dime. Here's an Xbox. And get the child, so the child leave you alone and go away. And they do the same thing. Here's a basketball contract. You got the number one country record. A woman ain't never had a album number one record like Beyonce. There you go. And you happy.
making all the money, Mr. Man, Mrs. Woman? Who the one making all the money? And damn sure not you. You don't even have any TV. It's all their TV, all their social media. You don't control and run nothing. Just like a child don't have and control run nothing in their house. You're a child, boy. You want to be around people to make you feel like a man. I'm not going to do that because it's a lie. It's a lie. This is what they always say. That means you too. You're damn right. The difference between you and me is I recognize it. As I matured. Because I thought I was a Mr. Man too at one time. But then I began to think about exactly what is it that I'm looking for. For you, it might be good enough. It's not good enough for me. When we said man, we're going to get different definitions. What the hell is it? What is it we're looking for? If I had a panel, everybody have their own definition of what it's supposed to be. Like, damn, lions don't have to do that. Gorillas don't have to do that. Giraffes don't have to do that. Why we got to sit around,
what is the man?
One thing for sure, whatever it is, your happy ass not a man, you a boy. That's for sure. You bending over for a man. That's what you doing. You're a boy. Getting punked by a pedophile. You ain't no damn man. Do I need to put the link in the chat room? Bring your happy ass and show us how you, Mr. Man, that I'm off base, that I don't know what the hell I'm talking about? Because I could be wrong. I'm the only one on social media that will talk, and I will tell you I could be in error. You're not going to get it off because I got a lot of questions for you. You're not going to be able to stand the heat, Mr. Man. Manhood training. What is manhood training? What should it be? Well, we know that a man cannot teach a boy how to be a boy, how to be a male. That should be natural. But what you can teach is what is expected in your tribe, what is expected in your family, in your society. In primitive situations and a lot of ancient cultures, boys had to go through ceremonies, and women too. We're not talking about females, we're talking about males. And we call it manhood training. You cannot make no babies, you can't do nothing until you prove to that tribe that you are a warrior and you are a provider, you are a benefit to the family. So if you was in an ancient culture or even a primitive culture, most of y'all wouldn't have no children. You couldn't qualify because the only thing you did was talk slick, get some dumbass woman drunk and got some babies. That's what your happy ass done. You ain't went through no manhood training. In America, there's no manhood training by white people. By black people, there's no manhood training. They just send your little ass to public school. And they don't even teach you skills no more. They don't teach you car repair, basic plumbing, basic electricity. They just send you to school. What? Send you to school for what? What are they training the boys for? And now they're teaching you sex in school. They teach you sex in school. They're teaching your little boys sex in school. How to wear a damn condom. But don't know how to cook. You don't know how to sew. Boys should know how to cook. Boys should know how to sew. Boys should know how to type. All these are skills male and female should know. We get no training at all to survive. So that means we are a victim of those who do know. So we have all these welfare lines and all these welfare programs because they know the people don't have no damn skills that they can use to help themselves. And if you don't have no damn skills, you have no choice but to turn to crime. And so they make prisons for your boys to go to. And now girls, females are getting almost just as rough as boys are nowadays. Your boys and the girls going to prison, to death row. So we don't have manhood training. So what is a man? Our idea of manhood, basically, what I got from the Bible, what I got from the Quran. That's not your family. That's not your tribe. You didn't live 2,000 years ago. You didn't live for that was based upon their lifestyle, how they did things. And you also base your manhood on, well, Masa, that's how Masa live. Because that's all you know. Some of you get so upset with your young boys growing into men. I'm gonna send them to the military. Not to the fruit of Islam. I'm gonna send them to the military. I'm not going to send them to the Black Panther. I'm going to send them to the military. Which that's our fault. Because we should have a military. We should have something instead of our children going to our oppressors' military. We should have our own military where we pay them to fight for us. Not for them. Or some other foreigners, they should. Our children that go into the military should be fighting for us. So if something break out, we need to call our National Guard. Y'all want to get down? Let's get down. Cause that's what they get paid for. They get paid to be a soldier. They get paid to kill. You want war? Let's do it. Cause your blood is red. Just like mine is. Your brain can come out your skull just like mine can. Yeah, we might lose. But you're going to know you've been in a damn fight. Russia know they've been in a damn fight. Ukraine might mess around and lose. Going on 3 years. But they know, Russia know they've been in a damn fight. But you, Mr. Man, you don't fight with nobody. You put on your best suit and you get a sign. We shall overcome. That's what you did in 1960, 1930, whatever. Still doing the same old corny ass stuff. And you got to go down to City Hall and get a permit. Sir, can I march? I got a permit. How much is it? $100? We want the permit. We got a permit. You, Mr. Man, I'm going to march and do whatever the hell I want to. I don't need no damn permit. You ain't gonna permit me to do nothing. Manhood training. What is manhood? Man, we know what the men is. It's the male. It's the male in the society, in the tribe, in the family. The hood is the cover or the laws or the criteria or the qualifications to make you a man in our family. We don't have that in the black community. So we don't make men. We make ding-a-ling. Breeders. That's all we make. Breeders. And people who will work to benefit other folks other than ourselves. They become millionaires and leave our happy ass. But then at the same time, we didn't give them opportunity. Somebody else gave them opportunity. And then some of us who are in a position to give opportunity, we rip our own people off. And us as men, we sit back in the cut and let it happen. If we was men, none of that would go on. You a man and cannot give your children opportunity. They have to go to somewhere else. So why should they come back and do anything for you? Because somebody else outside of the family gave them opportunity. Mr. Man. And we as a people, we get, eight trillion, a lot of money out of society. But there's no men in the society. There's no control. Everybody just flipping around doing whatever. That's what manhood training is about. This is what we do. But there is no manhood training. So everybody can do whatever the hell they want to do, blah, blah, blah. If there was men in the society, I don't give a damn what the federal government said. I don't give a damn about what the state government said. This is what we do in our family, in our community. This is how we handle things. And if you got a problem, you come talk to the men. Because this is how we do it here. Stay out of our business. The same way Native American people are able to control and have laws over their own people, we should be able to do the same thing. If there was men. Mind your own business. We handle ours. They will come to our court. We will put them in our jail. Because they're ours. They're not yours. But since there's no men, we don't have any power, then we fill their prisons and their jails and their mental institutions with our children. So, manhood is nothing but what is expected of men in our family, in our society. We don't have that. Everybody can do whatever they want to, and look at the situation. Because there's no men to get it together. And you take your boys and we teach them this is what we do and this is what we don't do. That's why you got all these pussy crazy ass dudes on social media. They never had a man in their life. A daddy, a father figure, somebody that put some, gave you some a cream of wheat when you was a little boy. That ain't no damn man. He don't make the cream of wheat. He don't grow the trees to build the house. He didn't make the bricks. I'm going to send my boys to the military to be, teach them how to be a man. The military is not designed to make no damn men out of nobody. The military is designed to make you a killer. To make you a guard dog. Go sick them, Spot. That's what the military is. Go sick them, Spot. And that's what we do. I'm going to Ukraine. I'm going to Saudi Arabia. There's a lot of brothers probably listening to me right now. They've been in the military. And they send you wherever the hell they want you. Go sick them, Spot. Afghanistan, Iraq, whatever the hell they want. Go sick them. Go sick them, Spot. And there you go. Not because you are patriotic. Many of you joined the military because you needed the money. And that was the case of our people way back in the day. There was no opportunity. Go to the military. Risk your life for somebody who hates your guts. And they still hate your guts. You still waiting on them to give you justice. Things take time. Who the hell are you to make me wait on your happy ass? Things take time. No, you wait. I'm not waiting. Our Savior has arrived. And he ain't waiting no damn 100 years. He's here to take care of business right now. This gonna come to an end now. We don't have no men. So they say that a man is supposed to be the protector. Who do you protect? Didn't even protect your leaders. Malcolm dead. Dr. King did. It was easy assassination. There was no protection. Who the hell you protecting? Our people keep going back to jail, back and forth. Who the hell you protecting? We ain't protecting no damn body. Women, our sisters on the street corner still selling booty. You ain't protecting her. That's her choice. That ain't no damn choice. If she had a man is not going to watch his woman selling her butt to other men on the street. A man is not going to sit around, watch his daughters and his mothers strip in a strip down club. Your boy, matter of fact, your happy ass is there making it rain. You making it rain too. You're not going to tolerate that. But you do, because I'm telling you, well, nothing dealing with boys. I don't care how strong you think your daddy is, because I know some people get upset. My daddy, he a strong man. My daddy, my father, good daddy. He bought me a bicycle when I was 3 years old. I like my daddy. That's what you got, a daddy. Your daddy wasn't a man. Because he don't know what it was. We never been that before. We don't know nothing about how to function as men. Black unity is easy. Black unity is easy. But it's difficult when you're dealing with boys. Like when you're getting the children together for a basketball game and people trying to pick whatever. They start, I don't want him. I don't want to do that. Well, then one of the children said, well, that's my basketball. I'm going to take my basketball. So y'all can't play with my basketball. That's what I got to deal with. That's what I got to deal with on social media. Boys. They don't like what you said. You a doo-doo head. Here we are. These are grown. I know these guys. Some of them is probably old as I am. You a doo-doo head. If you go to my Facebook page, look, this is Savior's Day. This Savior's Day. a fruit of Islam, a Nation of Islam member who claimed they follow Louis Farrakhan, I said something they don't like. First, they invited me to listen to Savior's Day. Then they don't like what I had to say. I didn't say nothing disrespectful. These people follow leaders and don't even know what they do. That's not my job to go to let you know about what your leaders and get the information and show you. This is your leader. You're supposed to know what your leader doing. So he's going to write, I hope you have a heart attack. I hope Allah give you a heart attack and die. What kind of crazy, what kind of sense, childish. I've had more than a heart attack. I had cancer since 2020, sir. So you giving me a heart attack don't mean nothing. And they told me I've had heart attacks, small heart attacks. So I've had small heart attacks and I have cancer. So what? When you finish, you a doodle head. Ain't nothing. It's nothing changed. The reality is still there, sir. But you're dealing with boys. What do you provide? Y'all said it means well. What do you provide? I'm waiting for somebody in the chat room. Matter of fact, we are simulcasting on Angel Snub Number 7 YouTube channel. And I'm going to check Facebook. I know this is Sunday. Shout out to Facebook, Brother Waheed Muhammad, and I cannot pronounce your name, Ndugu. I said Ndugu. You know, I don't know your name. Shout out to Facebook. Shout out to our brothers there. But look at here. You're a provider. That's what you say. What do you provide? This is what you provide. Your dingling. That's all. You're a breeder. That's all you basically can. And see, this is the thing. This is what you must understand. I don't care how good you think you are or we are as individuals. Don't mean nothing. I'm talking about us as a gender. It's just like when you said, well, the white man do this and the white man, but that's a lie. Because all white men did not do this and all white men did not do that. But because a certain group of white men did something, you say the white man did this. That's not fair because you don't want that on you. Because the stereotype is we like chicken and watermelon, which I do. I like fried chicken and watermelon. But all black folks don't like chicken and watermelon. But we all put into this category. Or we all have this criminal behavior. So that's why the white folks, the old white women, have to be in the store and hold their purse because the bad old black man snatched their purse. That's not us. As a people, that's not us. But somebody put that out there and the whole gender had to take the heat. So I know a lot of us would want to do better. But our gender is messed up. And I don't give a damn if you came from a single mother or a two-parent household. It don't make no damn difference. You show me how these men coming from a two-parent household is better. They've done something greater than brothers that came from single mothers. Put in the chat room. I want to see your high and mighty, arrogant, egotistical, narcissist's ass. You ain't special. You ain't did nothing great. Because you had two parents in the household. So what? You ain't no damn man. Who do you protect, Mr. Man? What do you provide? Came from a two-parent household. What do you, what do, and this is something they don't never add. A man should have wisdom. He should be smart. He should be competent. But we call anybody a man as long as they have a penis. Oh, you a man. You're a strong black man. But he's an idiot. We know he's stupid. Can't hardly talk.
Duh. What is he talking about?
I don't listen to nobody like him anyway.
Duh. Dude.
You a man, but you can't mess with me. You can't even handle words. You can't even express yourself. Do a head. As a man, you know that you're taking the position of leader. That means you're responsible for everything. Just like the manager at McDonald's, you are responsible for everything. But when you get in trouble, these doodoo heads, the black woman do this, or even the white woman do that, which Caucasian men don't really trip off of it like that. But we in bad shape. We know we ain't did a damn thing. And so black woman do this, and the black woman do that, and black. But you want to be leader. If you don't like the condition of the earth, men are responsible. Point blank, that's it. You can't blame nobody else. Who keeps the earth with these wars and fighting? It's men. And they justify with their male God, who is just as violent. Because if you look at the scriptures, Quran or the Bible, this male God is very, very violent. Jealous, envious. A murderer. But as we know that God does not exist, so this image or this idea of God is in the image of the man that created this God. And these are not men, these are boys. Women don't have any men in the world. Only boys could do what these are doing right now. They boys. When you talk about black women, you're talking about yourself. Because it shows you have no power, you have no control, you have nothing. Whatever pitiful condition this woman is in is because of you. You have no control, you can't provide, you can't protect, you can't. The only thing you got is a ding-a-ling. You a breeder. And that's why most of your talk is about your damn penis. What you can do to a vagina. That's all you're talking about. That's the only power you got. That's the only power you have. You have no wisdom. You are incompetent. You can't protect nobody. You don't provide a damn thing. You just a servant to another man. You want her to submit to you while you drop your drawers and give your booty to another man. You don't want to hear that. And I don't care how nice you are, brother. Our gender is in bad shape. We're not men. We don't qualify.
Oh, Mary, you talk about yourself.
This is what they do too.
Oh no, you talk about yourself. You ain't talk about me. You talk about yourself.
But when you get in trouble, you ask the white man, how much is my bond? When you want to go overseas, how much, Master, how much is a passport so I can go overseas? How much taxes I got to pay, Master? Mr. Man. But you a man. You only impress weak ass people. Weak ass women, weak ass children that don't know no better. They accept your weakness. I don't do that here because I know we're stronger and we're better. You're called a man by default. And yeah, okay, I'll give you the benefit of a doubt. You a man. I'll give you the benefit of a doubt. You a man. Man is the noun, and weak is the verb, and the verb describes the noun. Yeah, you a man, weak man, pathetic man, loser man. That's how you're described. That's the reality of you. Social media shows how weak you are. All these corny groups, Kevin Samuels is departed. They still going on with that nonsense. Ain't talking about nothing of substance. Nothing. They want even the Caucasian men, whatever they got, they fought for it, they died for it. You want somebody to give you something for free. You don't want to earn nothing. Treat you like a man, like you done something. You ain't done nothing. When you fight for other men. When you provide for other men. You don't provide for your own women and children. You provide and you live just to be a servant to other men. Your God don't even belong to you. You got your God from Arabia, the Middle East, some damn where, China. Your God didn't even come from yourself. What's man about you? Then you don't tell these people about their God that you got from them. Well, that's not what Allah ain't talk to your happy ass. Allah talked to them. Allah ain't said a damn thing to you. Jesus didn't come to you. Jesus went to them. So like we said, protect. What do you protect? This is Savior's Day. Today is Savior's Day. And yesterday, they were, I was part of it. You get on the stage, the fruit of Islam. Praise due to Allah, to the left flank, to the right flank, to the we got a military, brother. The fruit of Islam. How many battles? The fruit of Islam been around for 100 years, right? How many battles have the fruit of Islam fought? Now, the Black Panthers look like a military. I don't think they ever really claimed to be some type of military group. But we know the Black Panthers actually went face to face with the enemy. Even, it's a group of brothers, they don't talk about a lot. In the South, they picked up guns to protect Dr. King. Put in the chat room, what's the name of them brothers? Deacons of Defense. Deacons of Defense, I believe that's what they was called. And we know the Civil Rights Movement, they went face to face with the enemy. They could
was the Black Panther Party. But here we are, we have the fruit of Islam been around 100 years. Who did they fight? They beat each other up. They beat brothers and sisters up. Killed Malcolm X. Drowned babies in the sink. This is your military. You want to brag about your military. What have your fruit of Islam, what enemy have they fought since 2010? The only thing they know how to do is have a million man march, which is nothing but a church revival. No men are going to tolerate this type of behavior. It's corny. I'd rather be dead than you disrespect me as a man. It's simple as that. Mr. Man, you're a man. Don't have the sense of a bird. Before you can lay an egg, birds build nests. And a lot of times, it's usually the male bird will build the nest. Anyway, before you lay eggs, you build a nest. That's what you have to do. Here you are supposed to be Mr. Man. You have no house to put your children in. You still living with your mommy and daddy. You still in high school, Mr. Man. You have no house for your girlfriend. So she got to go to the welfare, Mr. Man. She got to get Section 8, Mr. Man. You want me to respect that type of behavior? You want me to make excuses for that? Keep your ding-a-ling in your pants. There was a time in our community, men used to do that. Men had to get a house. You had to prepare for your family. You get married a woman, and then y'all have children. You got to prepare for that. Now these women accept you, spread their legs, dumbass women. Spread their legs for you because you give them a coke and a smile. Then they complain.
Oh, where he at? He ain't no father to my children. You knew that.
He just gave you a coke and a smile. You didn't ask, are you qualified to get between my legs? Because my legs is not cheap, sucker. Any Looney Tune, he don't even have to have money in his pocket. He just got to have smooth game. And he might wear a suit. And y'all can have fun, because your boys and girls ain't no grown woman looking for no damn fun. Ain't nothing fun about laying on a table with labor pain, spitting babies out. Ain't nothing fun about that. I've never had a baby, but I know damn well there's nothing fun about this big old child coming through out your body. It's impossible for it to be fun. But this is how brainwashed and messed up the females are. Because even female animals just don't allow anybody between their legs. Well, on top, doggy style, whatever. They are picky and choosy. Give you some drugs, give you some weed, smile in your face, and here come the dangling, because that's all he got. He can't protect you. He can't provide. He's stupid as hell. He has no wisdom. He's incompetent. So what kind of children are these kind of people going to produce? Stupid, incompetent,
idiot children. And that's what you got. And so the white man know they coming. Might as well make some money off of them. Build some prison. Make jobs for our people. Make jobs for our people out of your stupid behavior. There's lots of birth control. You can fix yourself. No, but you boys. See, boys and girls don't understand responsibility. Boys and girls are supposed to be taught responsibility by their parents. But your mama is a girl and your daddy is a boy. So you don't know no better. This is not just didn't happen. You got boys and girls having babies. And you think your boy daddy is a man, and you think you're just because your mama spit you out, she's a woman. They're not. They're boys and girls. Just like Prince said. Boys and girls, do 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 do. Remember that Prince song? Boys and girls, do, do, do. Boys and girls. Something wrong with me, ain't a damn thing wrong with me. Cause I've been looking for a man all my life. And I know these, what I see, it's not it. Too weak for me. I don't want to be that. You don't qualify in my world. Manhood in my world, you're going to respect me whether you like it or not. In my world, when these sisters say they got a man, he may not be perfect, but damn it, she knows she got somebody. Not no boy. Old ass. Still foaming at the mouth because you saw some titties. Are you crazy? Are you serious? These so-called men on Instagram, what's that crap these women do? And they show that they don't, some of them might go full naked. Anyway, you have to pay to see their special pages on Instagram. These men paying these women $1,000 to see some woman's booty. What the hell wrong with you? You talk about you always talk about the single mothers. Where are these young girls' daddy at? And you don't never talk about their daddy. But see, that's why we need manhood training. This wouldn't be going on. And clearly, your Bible, clearly your Quran has failed. Your Savior has not arrived. You have not been saved. That's the reality. If you have been saved, there would be no need for me to say anything. I could easily keep my mouth shut. If you was actually creating full functioning men, full functioning women, I'll take my page down. There's no need for me to say nothing no more. You boys and girls, even though you claim you had a savior, you're not acting, you're not moving, you're not thinking like full functioning grown adults because you're copying another boy, the boy in the White House. I mean, look how childish this whole election is. Biden and what's her name, Haley and Trump. Look how they act. It's all childish and silly. How can anybody take these suckers serious? And they're going to be the leaders making laws and telling folks, oh, whoo. Somebody told me it was a blessing that cancer didn't kill you. I don't know. I don't know. To continue to live in this stuff. This stupid. I just don't get it. That's because you're a doo-doo head. You're a doo-doo head. We almost done. We almost done. We don't see the woman as a woman. We see her as a little girl. We see her as a toy, like a Barbie doll. We don't take women serious at all. Because the male has been conditioned to fall in love with himself. Woo! And you talk about gay folk. Ain't nothing. How gay is that? Your God is gay. Your spirit, your books, everything about you gay. The only thing you do is quote men all day long. You put men, you a male, and you put men on the wall. That's everything about you is male. But there's nothing gay about you. You don't see her. Even in the Nation of Islam, they teach to protect the black woman. That's what Malcolm was doing. But when the leader crossed the line, you will protect the man. But you're taught in the Nation of Islam, protect the black woman. And that's what Malcolm was doing. No more, no less. That's what he was taught. But since the leader was the one violating, he gets a pass. Because y'all boys. Because men would say, hey, leader. Because nobody is above scrutiny. The Nation of Islam teaches there's no big eyes and little you. Well, sir, see, Elijah Muhammad should have been put on trial. Let's see what's going on here. Malcolm X asked for a trial. They refused. They refused because they knew exactly what the deal was. And all of it would have came out in the wash. That's why a lot of people don't want to go to trial. I'll settle out of court. I'm going to settle out of court because it's going to be a lot of stuff, even things that don't have nothing to do with the case, is going to come up. Let's settle out of court. That's all Malcolm was doing. But you in love with men. Let's protect Elijah Muhammad, little scrawny ding-a-ling. I love Elijah Muhammad. You have men that love Elijah Muhammad more than their own mother, their own wife, their own daughter. But you not gay. He saved my life. If he saved your life, why are we still in the condition that we're in? He saved your life. Ain't nobody been saved. What, because you got a job now? I didn't have a job, but I met Elijah Muhammad. Now I have a job. There's a lot of people got a job, didn't meet Elijah Muhammad. There's people that's millionaires, don't believe in God, never met no savior. You didn't need that. You need to think for yourself. So our Soul Liberation Day is giving credit to you, to your ability to think, your ability to endure. Think for yourself. I don't need no scriptures from 1,400 years ago, 2,000 years ago, from some people I don't even know. I can think for myself. That's what Soul Liberation Day is about. Your strength. I don't have to go to Saudi Arabia. I don't have to wait for a savior to arrive on a boat from Mecca. So who is stronger? You who laying around waiting for your savior to get on a boat from Mecca, or me able to solve my problems myself? Who the strongest one? Because I don't need nobody. You do. You have no wisdom. You have no thinking capability. Then you have the nerve. Christians, y'all have the nerve. Muslims, you have the nerve to talk about King Solomon. King Solomon is described as a very wise person. Where is your wisdom? Give us an example of how your wisdom solved a great problem like King Solomon. Put it in the chat room. I notice we're not gonna get any examples. Put in the chat room. I'm gonna keep an eye on our other channels. Put in the chat room what we as black men, our gender, show us, or even as an individual, show us how we are wise as King Solomon. What we've done. You're not gonna be able to do it. Because you're a boy. You got to be a man. Boys can't do it. How you going to build a nation with the mentality of a boy? How you going to make babies first and then build a nation later? You build a nation, you get resources. You provide your military to protect what you build. You get your nation ready, then you start making babies. I'm building a nation, but you spend babies in the nation of another man, under the rules of another man, under the influence of another man. What sense do that make? You have no idea what you're talking about. We're going to build our own black nation. You ain't going to build a damn thing. The best thing you're going to do is like little children, you're going to get those little blocks. That's the best building you're going to get. And you think that you're saying something when you describe yourself as a lion or an elephant. Some of you said that you sheep. I see why. You never hear me describe myself, I'm the great lion or the great crocodile or the great bear. Because I'm a man. Why would I describe myself as a lion when man has proven he's greater and more powerful than a lion? I don't even have to fight you, Mr. Lion. I take this little pistol with this little piece of lead and take you out, sir. Ain't worried about no lion. Mr. Lion, I will put you in a zoo so my children can come by and watch you, Mr. Lion. Mr. Lion, I will put you in a circus and get you to jump through rings, Mr. Lion. So why would I compare myself, want to call myself a lion when man has conquered lions? And bear and crocodile. That's why you see throughout time, men used to worship these animals, crocodiles and bears and lions and whatever. But as time went on, they stopped doing it because they was kicking these animals in the ass. They weren't threats like that no more. They used to worship these animals like God, and they stopped doing it. Because they're kicking God in the ass. So now they turn to the God is invisible. It's going to be hard to beat that. And God is everywhere, visible. Hard to beat that one. But they kick these other gods in the ass. Why would you want to be that? You have wisdom. You claim you have wisdom. But you're always regurgitating and copying what another man said. There's nothing original. There's nothing unique about your own. There's nothing about your own. You bring nothing to the table on your own, Mr. Man. You're quoting dead people from 1,400 years ago. You're quoting dead people from 2,000 years ago. So what? What do you bring to the table? You have no wisdom. You offer nothing, Mr. Man. Out of all the years you've been on this planet, you can't offer nothing. Look at King Solomon. His wisdom was creative. His wisdom unique. His wisdom original. Even though he didn't exist, we're just using this for an example. King Solomon was not quoting from the Bible. King Solomon was not quoting from the Quran. He wasn't quoting from no other sources. King Solomon was showing, I'm smart myself. I'm intelligent myself. I can solve problems myself. I don't need no outside. King Solomon did not even call out to God. I don't remember reading where King Solomon, oh God, give me the wisdom. He didn't say that. It came from within himself. But you're a boy, and boys need the help of their parents to solve their problem. Mama, daddy, what you think? Because children are immature. Children don't think like that. They need guidance from a higher source. And that's why you're a boy. How dare you call yourself a God? You ain't nothing like no God. God don't ask nobody to do a damn thing for him or her. God don't ask nobody to do nothing. God is self-sufficient. Parents are supposed to be self-sufficient. The children ask them for things. They don't ask the children. You gotta ask the white man. You gotta ask the Arabia, Arabs, and Israel. Because you have nothing. You have nothing to offer. The only thing about you, the only way you feel like you're a man is because of your ding-a-ling, chasing pussy. Oh, the pussy, ooh, nothing like pussy. Look at my children. Look at all my children I got, because I got me some pussy. I bet you never had pussy. That's why, I knew that's why he mad, because he ain't getting no pussy. Doo-doo head, see how childish. So you got all these children. You have all these children. And you offer nothing. You're going to have to tell your children, you got to go get this from another man. You got to go to the white man or Arab or Mexican or whoever. You making all these children can't provide a damn thing. You provide no electricity. You provide no internet, no social media, no oil, no gas. No rubber, no nothing except a swinging ding-a-ling. That's all you got. That's all you have. And you don't have to like what I say. Because that's the way the world look at us. And that's how you're treated. Jokesters. Sex fiends. Dope addicts. Whores and whoremongers. And even the so-called holy and righteous people, they doing dirt behind closed doors. Because you have no discipline. Children don't have discipline. And they doing dirt behind closed doors. But they put themselves out in the public like they holy and righteous. We have these religions. It's natural for a man to be with a woman. It's natural for a woman to be with a man. But when you become an adult, you gotta have discipline because you creating and you getting You getting life involved, and you become responsible for life, and that's no joke. You raising children like you do your dog and your cat in your house. Matter of fact, some of y'all treat your dog and your cat better than your children. Your dog got better health care than your children do. That's because you're copying white folks. You got these pit bulls. I don't care how poor these niggas is, they going to get a dog, a pit bull, put in the house. No food in the refrigerator for the children. They got a pit bull in the house. Got a pit bull in the backyard on a chain. Crazy. What's wrong with you? Boys and girls, children. Children don't have no priorities. Children have no discipline. Children don't think. Children just, I want what I want when I want it. Daddy, can I have it? Mommy, can I have it? That's how we are. You a man. And you know you don't know. But your wife know. But I'm a man. You a man and you unemployed. But your wife work. But you so much of a man. You can't acknowledge what she know. You can't acknowledge the paycheck that she bringing in while you playing video games all week. I'm a man. Now, you can make money playing video games nowadays. Yes, you can. So why don't you do that with your lazy ass? I'm not going to give you credit. I'm not going to give you a title that you did not earn. If you want that, you need to go somewhere else because it's not going to happen here. And sooner or later, you're going to run into somebody like me, Mr. Man. They're going to show you, and the police going to show you, your happy ass is not a man. The Internal Revenue Service is going to show you, you're not a man. So you can get angry at me all that you want to. You can call me doo-doo head all you want to. I know you're not going to like this, religious folks. We almost done. Happy Savior's Day. Shout out to Black Superman. Shout out to Lunch Break Chronicles on Angel Snuffing Up 7 YouTube channel. Shout out to our Facebook. We are simulcasting. Happy Savior's Day. And we already did our Savior's Day, Soul Liberation Day. Free your mind, and the rest will follow December the 7th last year on our channel. If you haven't watched our Soul Liberation Day, please check it out. And with all humility, I say that Soul Liberation Day is much, much better than any Savior's Day message that you will find that anybody is talking about. I would say that this message that we're bringing right now, Black Manhood Training Course 101, is better than any Savior's Day message that you're hearing today. I dare you to put what we do here back to back against what Farrakhan is saying, or Eric Muhammad, or Silas, or anybody. Put this message on Savior's Day, put it next to him and compare it. And you're going to find out that this here is the message that you should have heard years ago. Get your act together so that you can progress. Stop waiting on a Savior. The Savior is when you look in the mirror. The Savior is your own brain. Think for yourself. A man A real man cannot accept the God concept.
What?
What you... A real man cannot accept the God concept. Because a man is not going to bow down to another God or some whatever. He's not going to bow down. You don't see lions doing that. They're not going to bow. Men don't bow. I'm not going to bow down to another man. I'm not going to bow down to some superior. I'm not going to be a... Because you taking me from being a man or being God myself, and you making me your... Get ready to say another word. But make me your slave. I'm not your damn slave. The God concept represents the master and a pet. And I'm not going to be your pet. God, I don't give a damn if you're an alien or whatever you're supposed to be. I don't give a damn what kind of power you have. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to bow down to you, sir. Men who submit to the God concept are not true men. They have taken on the position of being the pet of somebody. Come here, Fido. Come here, Scruffy. Come here. And that's what you do. Oh, Allah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, whatever. And you waiting for him to pet you on your head. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Allah. There you go. How embarrassing. What kind of woman? Why would you want a man like that? And then he's so embarrassed, he want to turn and make you a pet. And the children. Because somebody made a pet out of him. The kind of man you are in the God concept is like your male dog running to you with his female and his puppies. And he running to you because he depend on you. That's your slave. Your pet. Animals in the wild would never do that. You have to be domesticated. You have to have a pet mentality. He can't do nothing. That dog, that male dog, cannot do nothing without your permission. Not even mate. And this is the situation you're in with this, in the male, this God concept. You're a pet. You're somebody's pet. And if you're comfortable being on a farm, then so be it. Don't ask me to be on your farm with you. I'm not looking for a massa. I'm not nobody's pet. You a man, you're supposed to be independent. How are you independent when you need God? You need somebody to help you do something. Because you're a pet. You're a slave. And we really think we saying something. When we talking all this God stuff and how powerful God. You telling me how powerful your massa is. He's a strong, powerful massa. He can blow up the earth and he created the heavens and earth. My massa. I don't give a damn about it. I'm not impressed. These other males on the earth, a male ant, that male ant know I can just stomp him. He's not going to submit to me. So what? I'd rather get stumped. I don't give a damn about you. But when you're domesticated, when you're institutionalized, you can accept that type of programming because you're weak. You say that you're a man. We're gonna get out of here in a second here. Well, not a second. It's going to take another few minutes. Just be patient with me a little bit. We're going to get out of here. You say that you're a man. But we know you wasn't a man. We know our ancestor was not a man on the slave plantation. You was a slave. And a slave is not a man. A slave is property to a man. Then, because of their civil war, they set our ancestors free. So we know that you wasn't a man. And just because they set you free, don't make you no man. So my question to you is this. When did you claim that you Mr. Man? We know that you wasn't a man on the slave plantation. We know that you wasn't a man when they let you off the slave plantation. We know that you wasn't a man during Jim Crow. Your happy ass wasn't a man. We know your happy ass wasn't a man during the Black Codes. My question to you is, when did you become a man and a woman? And how did you do it? How do you qualify? What made you turn into some, just because you got a ding-a-ling, just because you got a vagina, you a man, you a man and a woman? Is that what make you a man? Is that all? That explains why you're so damn weak. Your idea of manhood, your idea of womanhood is copying the slave master, trying to obey somebody's God in the Bible and the Quran. That's your idea of manhood. You have no other. You didn't get nothing from Africa. You keep talking all this African stuff. You didn't get nothing from no African. Maybe if you did, you'd be acting differently. Because a lot of those people back in the day, you had to go through manhood training. You go through no kind of training at all. You just a penis and a vagina, just confused, going anywhere that you find yourself. Ain't nothing man or woman about you. If white people took their assistance away from you, you wouldn't have nothing. The only thing you know how to do is be comfortable here and buy things with the money that they allow you to earn. Because there was a time when they didn't let you do those things. But they allow you to win the lottery. They allow you to get those monies because they know that you boys and girls, you just want toys. Woo! You just want toys to play with. And that's what we see. You want a big Barbie doll house. That's what you want. And you want to feel like you're in competition with the white folks. There are Caucasian people in this country who are millionaires, you will never know. Don't even live that way. I knew a white guy that was a millionaire. And he drove his 1975 broken down looking station wagon. You will never know. You never know that man was a millionaire. Probably was a billionaire. He didn't live that way. But you, because you're a slave and you're a nobody, soon as you get your little money, you got to bling, put on the all the designer clothes and do all that because you're trying to prove something because you've never been nothing all your life. And you think things give you value. If things give you value, why they didn't put these things in the coffin with Michael Jackson? Because these things don't mean nothing. But you think you need something to give you value. You believe in God because that gives you value. That gives you a sense of purpose. Because you don't think much of yourself. So you need to believe in God. God gives you value. You nothing. And you even say it. I'm nothing without God. You even say it. And we get so happy because we take a picture with a celebrity or the mayor or the president because that gives us value. I got a picture with the president. I got a picture with Denzel Washington. Who gives a damn? Because it gives you value. Make you feel because you don't have no value in yourself. I don't need to take a picture with no damn body to have value. I don't need God to give me value. I don't need a holy book to give me self-esteem. Because I'm striving and learning and growing to be a man, and I don't need those things outside of myself. Everything that come to life, life already is waiting and give you everything that you need. You don't need to get nothing from nobody. If you don't have it, chances are you don't need it. Trying to be like them. I don't want to be like them. I don't want your holy Quran. I don't want your Bible. I want my own. I don't want your hand-me-down stuff. So when did you become a man? Put in the chat room. Facebook. Angel Snuffed Up 7 YouTube channel. Here. Put it in the chat room. When did you become a man? And why? When? How? And show us how you provide. How you protect your resources, your military. How you independent. Because you're a man, you big shot. We as a gender, we must become men, full functioning men. Anybody can sling ding-a-ling. And this is a problem too. It's natural for man to want a woman. But when you let that interfere with you functioning as a human being, you got a damn problem. Running around. You always got to be sniffing in somebody's underwear. What a pitiful man you are. I saw a video with Dr. Umar Johnson. The title of the video, I didn't watch the video, I just saw the title. Title of the video, asking black women, don't wear weaves. Why you gotta ask? If you was a man in your society that you build, it wouldn't even exist. But you're not a man. And in this society, the man who actually run it said, you can do whatever the hell you want to do. So you got to be a little wimp. And at the same time, men wear weaves. Men wear weaves too, sir. It's always always directed toward women. Women don't do this. Women don't. Well, what are you going to do? Give me my electricity. Give me my internet. Build me some houses, some Section 8 houses or whatever. What you going to do for me? These men have all these demands on these women. Don't do this. Don't wear that. Don't do the weed this. Don't do the. You making all these demands on these females. What the hell you going to do? What you going to do? Like nothing wrong with you. In Chicago, I believe these drive-by shootings or whatever is still going or whatever. Why aren't you stopping? Children can't go to school. Gotta be afraid to get shot. These gangs run around here. Won't you stop that? Make a deal with the women. If we stop the gangs, we stop the drugs in the community, then will y'all stop wearing weed? I'm pretty sure that would be a good deal. Because nobody want to get shot. Women wearing weeds get shot by drive-by bullets. If that'll stop me from getting shot, hey, I won't have to wear the weeds no more. You're making all these demands on people. What you going to do? Absolutely nothing. Reason why you got to ask the women, because you have no control. You don't run nothing. You don't control nothing. Crazy men produce crazy ass women, crazy ass children. And the thing about it, you think ain't nothing wrong with you. And there's something seriously wrong because you're not a man. You're not a full functioning man. I'll make a deal with you. Make a deal with the women. I will give you your nation. And I don't want to lay down with you until I give you electricity. Until I'm making cars for you. Baby seats for you. Grocery stores for you. Factories so that you can work. When I prove and show you I'm a man, will you do that for me? Oh, that's too much work. You don't want that. Because you're not a man. You want somebody to call you a man. And you don't qualify. And what? That's the reason why they call you boy. And I'm not gonna call you no man, not here, until you prove it. And if you prove it, I can shut down my channel. Because now you're on the right path. You're doing what you're supposed to do. There's no need for me to say anything anymore. There are those who don't understand the vision that we have here called Operation Exodus Mississippi Campaign. They're not trying to learn what it's all about. And then they want you to tell them so they can steal your ideas because you don't have no idea. There's nothing creative about you. You still talking about 1930, 1950, 1970, 5,000 years ago? So you can steal from our ideas here. That's why you really want me to go into detail how we're going to do this and how we're going to do that so that you can steal the idea. To do nothing. You ain't going to do nothing. You just want to steal certain parts and use it for yourself. But that's not how the Mississippi campaign works. Mississippi campaign is put together in a manner, you got to put it together and do it the way it was designed to do. All these different You can't pick and choose because I like this part and I don't like that. That ain't how things work. You can't drive a car picking and choosing. All the parts have to be there and work together in order for the car to drive and operate properly, dumbass folks. But that's because you children. That's how children do. I don't like that. You ever see children play with a toy and they'll take this piece out of the toy? I don't like this and blah, blah, blah. Then look stupid. How come it stopped working? Oh, maybe because you went in and took out stuff that you didn't like or whatever. Maybe that's the reason why it didn't work, little Johnny.
Oh, is that, did I do that? You a doo-doo head.
We must earn our manhood. You call yourself the black man is God. And you look stupid and dumb. What earth have you created, Mr. God? Where's your power? What do you do as a God? The black man is God. Some of y'all never even left your city in all your life. But you created the universe. What is your special powers? When you think about God, you think about power. I can say I'm Superman. And if I say I'm Superman, people expect me to fly. Show us your x-ray vision. Hell, do you got a cape? Do you got a cape? You calling yourself a god and can't demonstrate nothing except talk. Run your damn mouth. And you think folks are supposed to be impressed because you read Message to the Black Man. So? What godly thing that Elijah Muhammad did or Master Farah Muhammad did? They ain't did nothing godly. Ain't nothing godly or special about teaching somebody some religious stuff. Did they black out the sun? Did they make the earth spin faster? They ain't do nothing. Then people make claims that Allah do this and Allah do that. But there's no proof Allah did nothing. There's no evidence. That's why it's called belief. And you can believe in it if you want. But an adult, a grown man, you're not going to do that. It's not acceptable. That's just not acceptable. You want to call yourself a warrior? Where's the fights you've been in, sir? I'm a warrior. Black man is a warrior by nature. What war you been in? What fights you been in? Going back 2010 to now, what fights you been in? What kind of warrior you are? What kind of warrior you gotta ask women, could you stop wearing weeds, please? What kind of warrior? What kind of warrior are you? You only fool yourself. And the reason why you accept these things is because you're not a grown man. You are a boy. You're not a full functioning male. You have no idea. You've never been a man. Been on a slave plantation for 300 years. You have no idea of what it is to function as a full functioning man. And even if you get to that level, you're going to understand that these other men around the earth, they're not men either. They behave as boys and girls. Our Savior has arrived is nothing spooky. Our Savior has arrived is when the human being finally evolves and matures to be the human being, a full functioning man and woman, instead of a child. And that's what we have here as children. Nothing but children. And that's why there's always problems, why always violence, why there's always something going on. And that's why you will not leave your children without a babysitter, because children are unpredictable. Children are immature. You don't know what might happen. And this is the reason why we are in the condition that we're in all over the earth, is because children are ruling the house. But when mommy and daddy come, it's over. It's time for us to grow up and become men and women. This, what we think is manhood and womanhood, still child. An adult would not be impressed by none of this. An adult is not impressed by what you got. Your little funky money. Your fame and fortune. Whatever the hell you think. Even your God. I don't care about that stuff. Because I don't need your God. I don't need your money. I can get my own. And if I can't get it, I don't want it, I don't need it. So what? But you know how it is with children. Little Johnny got some Jordan shoes. I want some Jordan shoes. That's how we are. Look what the white man got. Look what the Chinese people got. Look what the Mexican people do. Like, damn, you're always comparing yourself what others got, what they doing. I don't give a damn about what they doing and what they got. I'm not trying to impress them. But that's in your mind. You gotta, because you have no value in yourself. I don't have to have a dime in my pocket. Nobody better than me. Nobody. I don't care what you have, I don't care what you say, I don't care what you do. You're not better than me. You don't think that way. You have to impress somebody. You have to get their approval. I got to get approved by God. I don't need God to approve me of nothing. God gonna destroy you. So be it. Get to destroying, sir. I'd rather be dead. I'm not your pet. I'm not your slave, sir. So we can have more conversations about manhood and go more into detail and be more technical, but this is the foundation. This is the strong foundation. The real foundation. You've been doing it the other way. Look where we are. Thank you so much for joining us this Savior's Day, this afternoon. Before we get out of here, we want to entertain some comments or some questions before we get out of here. Let me go see if anybody on Facebook has something. Something to say. Appreciate Facebook. Getting more action on Facebook. I appreciate those coming out and spending time with us this afternoon. Thank you so much. Facebook, that's our Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry Facebook channel.
Facebook. And of course, we're always going to have Elijah Muhammad cheerleaders, you know. Okay, what we say here? So how do you govern people? I really don't know. I'm not going to tell you I know. That's up to the people. You can't even answer that question unless you become free. Unless you become liberated, until you can take control of yourself. It really don't make any difference how you're going to govern yourself if people aren't free. At least free mind, because actually while we're here, we can govern ourselves. You are in a position and you're so confused and wishy-washy all over the place. In order to govern yourself, you have to be able to unify yourself. But you can't unify yourself because we're childish. We're childish people. It's hard to get children together. Because you're childish, and children hold grudges, and children are just children. They're silly. And that's what you see on social media. Trying to talk to somebody, these people are silly. We had a guy on the platform, last week or Monday or whatever. I think last Monday it was. He got upset because he didn't like what he was hearing. He started making these noises and shuffling around. You a doo-doo head. Silly people. Silly people. I don't know, they said something about when they read message to the black man or something like that. I don't know what that's about. If reading message to the black man solve our problems, and we've had message to the black man over 50 years, and we still having these problems, apparently, it does not even, message to the black man didn't even do nothing for the Muslims. When Elijah Muhammad died, their whole crap fell apart. Explain that. Message to the black man didn't even do nothing for them. So what can message to the black man do for the masses? And what is message to the black man except a book telling these old religious funny stories? That's all it do. How will we resolve a dispute? The same way disputes are always solved. You cannot resolve a dispute with people that don't want it to be resolved. This is why courts get involved. Courts get involved because people, individuals, cannot come up with anything. So we come up with various laws, different things, in order to resolve these issues. That's the purpose of it. But I would say this also in conclusion. When you do become a man, when you do put yourself in leadership position, you're always going to have problems if you don't lead in love. When you don't lead with justice and fairness, there's always going to be certain problems. Adults always supposed to be able to work things out. Find some kind of way to work things out. That's the purpose of the courts. Instead of Ukraine and Russia killing each other, why couldn't there be some kind of court you can go to and people make their case? But
no, we would rather kill each other, murder each other. The Palestinians are open for that. They have no choice. They don't have the firepower. But Israel don't want to do that because when you go to these different courts, they might rule not in your favor, so I'll take my chance with killing people. And that's why a lot of folks go turn to violence, because if a court is fair, and this is not to say that courts don't get things wrong, courts don't make errors, but when you create a court, it's supposed to be designed to try to come up with the most fair, just, that's why it's called the, supposed to be the justice system, the most just answer to whatever the problem it is. We know that in this country, it's discriminatory. We know that there's no justice in this country, but on our watch, it's important that such be done. Otherwise, we're going to stay in the condition that we find ourselves in. We don't want to be like the children that rule today. The reason why Malcolm X is gone, because you're dealing with people with childish mentality. That's the reason why Malcolm is gone. It should have been an easier, better way to deal with things. But when you deal with, that's how children can be violent. Just wait till after school. Just wait, that's what children do. Wait till after school. And that's what they did with Malcolm. Because you're dealing with children. Making threats on the phone. We watching you, Dr. King. Yeah, we're watching. Watch your back, Dr. King. Children. You know, scary. You know how children, I'm going to get you. And they put up their little fist. I'm going to get you after school. It's all of it so childish. You would think when we become adults, we've grown out of that. No. And so the children, looking at these so-called adults. And then the sad thing about it is, you know better. Oh man, I'm gonna say this, we're gonna get out of here. I saw a video, I think it was on Instagram. It was a young girl. She might have been 14 years old. And she was talking about the war, Palestine and Israel and Ukraine and Russia. She was saying, she was talking to the adult. I think she was talking to the United Nations. It was a bunch of nations there. She said, when I was little, growing up, she only 14 herself. She said, when I was little, growing up, you taught me how to share with other children. When I was little, growing up, you taught me, you know, you broke up fights and told us how to be nice to one another. But then, when I become an adult, I'm supposed to return right back to that. Basically, which I'm paraphrasing. But then, when I become an adult, I'm supposed to turn right back to this, to that same type of behavior. She told them, I don't understand. Look what you're doing. Destroying the endless murder of human beings, the destruction of the environment, the poison of the air and water. What y'all doing as adults? Nobody said nothing. That's why they will not come to me and try to debate me about what I say, blah, blah. They're not going to say, because you don't have no answer. You have no answer. And the sickening thing about it is they don't want to do better. But see, a man, like Clint Eastwood said in the movie, a man know his limitations. And if you can drive that car better than me, hey brother, you can drive that car better than me. There you go. You can do this better than me. Give it to somebody else. So we in a situation where we know we have tried certain things for at least 100 years and they don't work. What's wrong with trying something different? What's wrong with saying, let's try it that way for a minute. Let's see if that'll work. But we're children. This mine. Ain't mine. Can I come on your YouTube channel? Can I go on the same rostrum with Minister Farrakhan and present to the world our vision called Operation X? Nah, that ain't Muslim. Get out of here. You talked about the minister. We're childish. We're trying to solve a problem here. I don't care how big I ever get. I'll never be so high and mighty, a brother and sister. I can't share this platform with a brother and sister and help them. We so worried about other people getting the spotlight. That's what we worried about. Other people getting the spotlight. We feel embarrassment because we might present something that somebody else do and it work. And we feel embarrassed because what we've been doing for the last 20, 50, 100 years, it didn't work. We feel embarrassed. Why? Why? That's because you're childish. Your concern should be with changing the condition for the better of the mass of the people so we can do better. So every year, we don't have to keep talking about, we shall over. Every year, Savior's Day, we waiting for a Savior. Same every damn year. You should want to be saved. You should want to sing, we overcame. We should want to do the past tense. Now we've gotten over that obstacle. Now we on to do something else different. That's what you should want. Worried about other people. Matter of fact, they even told me, I ain't gonna give you no views. I even been told that. I ain't coming on my channel. I ain't giving you no views. Wow. Now, if you look at my record, of course, as you know, YouTube has torn down my work, my channels. But even the little stuff that's left, you see me promoting other YouTubers. I even have a channel on Daily Motion, I think. My channel with nothing but Nation of Islam videos. Nation of Islam don't have nothing with my videos on it. But I have a channel that I made just for Nation of Islam stuff. These people don't do it. I promote other YouTubers. That's what get me in trouble. That's why my channel had got flagged by Napar Shada, because I was promoting her channel on my videos, and she flagged her promotional video I had in my video. See how nasty that is? How you gonna flag somebody for promoting you? These people will flag you for promoting them. How sick you are. And then there's something wrong with me. I'm trying to promote your happy ass. They're not doing nothing for me. But that's because I'm real with mine. I don't only believe in black unity. I practice it. These people talk it. They're not about it. They're not real. It's all about them. I don't want you to get no views. Wow. How selfish. I told the Nation of Islam about Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign way back in 2018. Not interested. Because if it didn't come from them, they're not interested. They don't even want to talk about, because I might take the views away from them. But you're not doing anything. You're not accomplishing anything. How can you have thousands of views? How can you have thousands of subscribers? How can you have international recognition and you're not producing nothing compared to the recognition and the subscribers that you got? Explain that to me. How are you going to get angry at me simply because I'm telling you the truth? How you gonna get angry at me? Because I practice mine. There was a time before YouTube start tearing up my channels. There was a time where I was getting 300 subscribers a month. And I was sharing videos, promoting people. These people flagged my channel, and I donated to them. I gave them money, and they flagged my channel. This is what you're dealing with. There's people right now talking on YouTube. If it wasn't for me, they wasn't saying nothing. They came on my channel. I inspired them to start talking again. I raised them up from the social media dead. This is a fact. And they all turned on me. But I'm the problem. No, you're sick. You're not a man. You're not a woman. You're children. And that's what I have to deal with. The Quran talks about us striving to be upright. Because I don't call myself a man either. But I'm striving. Now I have an idea where manhood needs to go. And it's not where we're at. That's why we can't go anywhere. That's why we have not progressed. Because our Savior has not arrived. And that Savior is when we come into our manhood, we come into our womanhood, raise ourselves where we can show the rest of the world what manhood and womanhood really is. Because what we have today all over the earth are children. That's why the scriptures call you a child and call you a sheep. There's a reason. It describes a behavior. It describes a mentality. They say, comment here says, children need a leader, don't they? The parents are supposed to be their leader. Children need a God, won't they? God don't exist. And the only God that a child really knows would be their parents. That's fairy tales. Mythology. From a time when human beings was illiterate. So they made up stuff. Like children do. Children make up invisible friends. I know I did. You make up your little invisible friends. That's what children do. That's what illiterate ancient people done. But then you grow out of it. Some of us. I heard there are some adults who actually believe in Santa Claus. And you will laugh. You 45 years old. You believe in Santa Claus? You believe in Jesus? You believe in Allah and the mother plane and 72 virgins? You believe in all that? What you laughing about?
Do you hear?
We out of here, y'all. We out of here.
I thank you so much. I enjoyed Savior's Day, and probably I probably do housework tomorrow, and I will just I don't know if Minister Farrakhan spoke or not, but I'll probably do housework and play his Savior's Day. In fact, I'll probably listen to Eric Muhammad and Silas. I'll probably listen to all three of those brothers a little bit, because see, you cannot talk. See, you cannot talk about something that you didn't listen to, that you don't know nothing about. There are people who try to talk about Angel Snuff Nuff 7, and you don't listen to my video. You don't know nothing about me. That's why they talk about me if they do. They never quote nothing I say. They don't know what I do. They don't know nothing about me. Because you're too arrogant. Too high-sided. You know it all. Then I tear you apart. Destroy you. Like you're supposed to be destroyed. You don't mess with somebody or something that you don't know nothing about. So if I say something about Silas Muhammad, if I say something about Eric or Minister Farrakhan or Tariq Nasheed or Sanetta, that's because I heard them say it. And I can prove, I can quote them because I listen to what they're talking about. You can't do that with me. There was a man I thought was going to make a good video about me. And he didn't, because it would take too much work. He didn't want to go through my archives and try to find stuff that he could use. So he just made a 4-hour video of, you know, trying to make fun of somebody and slandering and gossip, stuff like that. But see, people like me and many others, the reason why our words hurt is because it's true. And I quote you, and I can quote you directly from your mouth. You said it. You done it. That's the difference. You look stupid trying to talk about somebody, and you don't know them like that. So on that note, send a shout out again to those who are listening, those who will be listening to this broadcast later. Of course, my Deacons of Reality, and I always with me in the chat room, Twin Pyramid and Soul Brother 85. Thank you so much. Always there for us. J2226, thank you. Been knowing that brother for a real long time. Black Superman in the house. And again, I invite anybody. There's no problem. You can come here, you don't like what I say, or you disagree, and you think that you have something better, or you can see, think, I'm open. AngelSnuffNuff7 at AOL.com. Send a request. Let's get this ball. Let's get this ball rolling. Shout out to our Facebook, Brother Wade and Brother, I cannot pronounce, Brother N. That's what I say, Brother N. So, you know, whenever you're ready. But the thing about it now, you know, you come here, you got to have your act together. Because it's better that you just be silent and leave us alone. Because you don't know me like that. You don't know us like that. You're going to get interrogated. You know what the brother said? One of the brothers that was here, I feel like I'm in court. I'm getting prosecuted. Yes, that's what you need to be. Yes, you are being prosecuted. And I thought that's what we want. I thought we wanted the truth. I thought that's what we want. I thought we wanted to bash falsehood until we bash out his brains. I forgot exactly how the quote is. Man, that's what they said in the Nation of Islam. Bash falsehood until you bash his brains out.
But see, really, you're not interested in the truth. You're only interested in the promotion of your belief. And we don't need belief no more. We need to know. I don't care what you believe. We need to know. And that's why I stand so strong, because I stand strong on what I know, not what I believe. And that's why it's easy to prove what you know. It's difficult to prove what you believe. You got a lot of explaining to do. When you know something, don't take a lot to explain. And you don't have to be spiritual. You don't have to try to diddle and dabble. You don't have to do all that. But you do when you have to, when you believe. Because belief is not factual. Belief does not require common sense. Belief does not require logic or reason or being analytical. If we was able to take these religions to court, woo, it'll be over. It would be over because they can't prove none of it. None of it. That's why it's called belief. And that's why the courts won't entertain it. Either you believe or you don't. The only way the courts get caught up in religion is when it comes to like embezzlement, cases of some other kind of fraud with the money or whatever. But as far as what you teaching and trying to prove, courts don't get involved in that kind of, you believe or you don't. And this is another thing I want to say before I get out of here, off the topic, in relation to this, this new law. Well, it's not a law, but it's the judgment by the Alabama courts about IVF, intro something, fertilization, whatever it is. They made that ruling, the court, the Alabama Supreme Court. I thought in this country it's supposed to be separation of church and state. But they show some of the rulings of what some of the judges said, and they made reference to Bible scriptures. I would appeal that. I would fight that just based on that. You're not supposed to be making no judgment about anything based on Bible scriptures and somebody's belief. But that's what it said in the ruling. It's supposed to be separation of church and state. This is why we need to separate ourselves. That's why we need to create our own, become men and women, and control and do our own thing. Because these people said, the Constitution clearly says, talks about separation of church and state. And you go to court, you got to put your hand on the Bible or the Quran or whatever. And they mixed, they still sneak their religion into the courts. So that makes, that defeats the purpose of separation of church and state. If people are allowed to bring in their, look at all the different religions in this country. You can't do that. Anyway, that's not a problem of mine. Ours is bigger. I'm concerned with our problems. Let us become men and women, and we can go on to do great things. And we can be stronger than a lion and a bear or what, all these things that we talk about that we are. You're even greater than your God. I said it. You're greater than your God. Because first of all, that God did not come from you. Your God came from overseas some damn where. It's not yours anyway. Belong to the Arabs, belong to Europeans, or somebody in Asia somewhere. You don't need it. You survived 300 years on a slave plantation, and you didn't need it. The Savior is yourself. The Savior is us becoming adults. It's simple as that. On that note, let's get out of here. Thank you for listening.
Facebook, Angel Snubnub 7, YouTube channel, and of course here. I thank you so much again for listening, giving me a little bit of your time. I appreciate it. And I welcome anybody who wants to debunk what I'm saying or whatever, which it can't be done. But I would like to see that. I don't even think they're going to even try. They're not going to try. But if you do, we welcome it. You could teach me some. Because unlike these folks, my mind is not closed. But they are. Like our ancestor Dr. Neelis used to always say, as in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul, and we are Audi 5000.